of my life.
Now I know you did not think that we would go straight into the proposal. Just wait, we're gonna build it up a little bit, see how we got here, and then we'll come back to it.
Okay, so let's just start with this.
Okay, sure.
Let's start with this, okay? So one of the questions that a large majority of people are asking is how did we meet? So I think that's an easy way to start.
We actually have on camera the first time we really met.
And we are here doing another AfterBuzz TV show for America's Got Talent. Tonight we'll be covering week one, night two, and week two, night one.
That's tricky. Yeah,
that's tricky. My name is Emile Ennis Jr. And tonight I'm joined with three lovely co-hosts. So I'll let them introduce themselves.
All right. I am Kira Batte.
Ladies first, of course.
And I'm Kaori Take.
And I'm AJ Gibson. Thank you. And I'm lovely.
Cover because I didn't want to reveal all the news that we have to share.
So you don't think that big old bling on your finger is revealing anything?
Also, there's a title of the video that probably gives it away. We have so many updates, but first, you ready?
Yeah.
Three, two, one. Fiance!
Oh, okay. Come on.
We both have yellow because, you know, Lemonade.
Oh, yeah.
Favorite Beyonce albums. Mm-hmm. They don't
love you like I love you. We love her. We love her. Also, thank you to our friend Erica for the magic.
Oh, they're so cute. These were engaging you. Y'all, so I'm sorry. It's been so long. Oh, first of all, Hello. Welcome back. Ooh, that was a little sharp. Let's redo that. Hello. Welcome back to my channel. Soon to be our channel because engaged.
Wait, I own half of this now?
Well, I mean,
okay.
You're on every video almost. We have so many updates, but it's been a whirlwind of we got engaged, we have a son, we have so many. Anyway, let's just get to it. So I'm excited. This has been a long time coming.
We got engaged in December.
Yes, it's been a while.
August.
Okay. And I've been enjoying the engagement process. Uh-huh. We're now starting, or we've started the wedding planning process. We'll give you guys updates on that later. But obviously, we've been living life in a global pandemic processing things, but we're engaged, and so many of my friends and some of you guys who are watching, maybe not if this is randomly on your YouTube feed and you're watching, thanks for joining us. This is AJ, I'm Emile, and we've been together.
He's engaged to me.
Oh. We've been together for a long time.
Yeah, 112 years.
Actually, we met in 2012, and people have been asking for a while, when are you guys getting engaged? And for different reasons we waited. We wanted to make sure we were good financially in our careers.
Also, there was the whole part where it wasn't legal until like 5 years ago.
Yeah, but then even after that, there was no rush for him to, so.
Yeah, we fought for the right, and we're like,
Yeah, but, pink lemonade break, that's what we'll call it. I think we should take them down the journey of our proposal.
Well, you're lucky because I don't know how to do any of this stuff, mm-hmm. but I know how to work my phone.
Yeah.
And so I recorded myself on camera a few times as I was going through the process of purchasing a ring, asking for his hand in marriage from his parents.
Oh, by the way, I haven't seen, so obviously I was there for the proposal, but, and you guys will experience it too, I have not seen any of the other footage because I wanted to experience it. I can't talk.
He's going to experience it live on the air. So yeah, he wanted to experience it with you, his followers.
That's your phone.
But I will say this has not led to any arguments whatsoever over the course of the last 6 months that he has not watched these videos that I so thoughtfully curated for him.
Somebody's a little salty.
Okay, so here's the first one. Wait.
Okay.
There's a folder.
Wait, should we introduce the dog first? Our son, Kingston.
Okay, spoiler alert.
Come here.
This is out of order.
Wait, don't eat that. Come here.
But we got a son.
No. Hey. No.
What's in his mouth?
He's eating a little microphone. Come out here. Come here. Come here. Come on. Come up and see daddy. Come on. Oh, now you don't want to hop up? Come on. Meet the people. Wait, why are you being crazy right now?
Why are you being lazy?
Meet the people. Oh.
Say hello.
Hi. You can look me. Okay, you got.
This is Kingston, our son. He's a king.
My mom is Jamaican.
Yes.
And she was born in Kingston, and so I'm half Jamaican, and so we thought it would be a fun name, and he's a king. So, Kingston, say hi to the people. Anyway, this is our son, but now let's get into what led to the proposal. To the proposal! To the proposal! And then the actual proposal. Okay, so what video should I watch first?
They're in order.
Okay. So this one?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, sorry. Quick side note before we get into all the proposal and all that stuff. We have a huge announcement.
Oh, we're doing that now? Yeah.
No, not at the end. You have to watch, you have to stay tuned. Oh, yeah. Don't skip forward.
It's good.
Stay tuned really for the end of the video. Watch the whole thing and you'll be excited. We're excited.
Hey. I don't know who I'm talking to right now, but I feel like I want to talk to somebody. So I just did a thing.
Your hair is cute.
I bought Emile an engagement ring.
Wait, it's the first video?
I'm so excited. I am sitting in a car right now, in his car, because I can't do this at home because he's always there because of the pandemic. But I'm super excited and I want to document the process because I know he's going to want to see this. He'll probably want to share this with people on YouTube, on his YouTube channel. So it's very 2020, I know, but it's one of the things I love about him. But
it's 2021 now. I'm sorry, y'all.
Yeah, we've been together 8.5 years, and I thought I might be nervous or anxious, but the minute I bought the ring, I felt really peaceful, which tells me that I'm making the right decision. I'm just really excited. He's literally the best person I know, and I can't wait to spend my life with him. We're about to get a dog. So we're starting a family.
Kingston's talking about you.
I just can't wait to give him this ring. I'm so excited. I waited a while. Like, we've been together a while, but I also come from a divorced family. My parents divorced when I was young and had a big impact on my sister and I. And my dad's been married 4 times. So I think that played into my delay a little bit, and then I was ready, and then the pandemic happened, and I kept having all these plans and they kept getting canceled, and somehow through this whole COVID-19 thing, we've been spending a lot of time together because he's been working from home and I was for a while, and we've gotten closer somehow, and I know a lot of relationships can't stay the same, but we've really just worked on our communication, and I just love him, and I'm a better man because of him, and I think he would say the same. So it's a good indicator that you found your person, and I'm really excited. So when I pick up the ring, I will definitely take you guys along for that. And we have plans right now to Zoom our families on Christmas morning. My mom sent out some gifts, and so did his mom. That's kind of my way of saying, hey, let's all be on camera together, and I'll secretly record it. And hopefully I can share some of that footage with you guys as well. Because I wanted both of our parents there, but that's been difficult to do because of this. I'm excited. Really, really excited.
Okay, so before we go through the next video, let me tell you what happened. So leading up to, you can come up here, by the way. Come here. No, not that way. That's my phone.
Why do you choose those?
You literally over here. I'm hiding over here. Wow.
Whoa.
Kingston. Okay. So leading up to getting Kingston, first of all, we were so excited to get Kingston, and it was just the process. And leading up to getting him, we were getting gifts from AJ's mom, Mama Cat, and we were getting like just super antsy and ready for him. And AJ randomly one day was like, "Hey, Michaela thinks that maybe we should record ourselves opening the gifts that your mom got for Kingston, because it's going to be like a nice little memory maker and keepsakes." And I was like, okay, I guess. And then he was like, and then we can do an introduction to Kingston.
Well, I tried to sell it as, hey, Emile, you could do we got a son.
Right.
We had a son video for YouTube because your followers would love that.
Right. That was the plan.
That was my
And initially idea. I was like, huh? But then I was like, oh, actually it would be a cute video because then we have the footage of opening the gifts and then we actually get the puppy.
Because like low-key, I mentioned on that video that I had other plans. Mm-hmm. I planned on proposing to him on the red carpet for the Billboard Music Awards at one point. Yep. I was talking to the team from the Wendy Williams show. We planned on doing it there. I thought about reaching out to Jeannie Mai and doing it on The Real when you were on. And we were trying to find all these really cool, because he said to me years ago, he wants it to be like big. So I'd had this sort of pressure in my mind.
Not big in terms of like a flash mob, but low big key. In terms of, no, I wouldn't want that. I would hate that. Big in terms of, I just didn't want like, I don't know what I wanted, honestly.
Basic, the two of us in our living room alone.
Anyway, but it was perfect. Let's get back to watching the videos. But that's what he told me was the plan. Okay, so this is the next video?
Oh no, this is just a picture I saw on the way right after I got it.
Oh, okay, so this photo is funny because 33 is like 33 is like it's
our number.
It's our number.
And it's our Jesus number, it's our number.
333 is one of the angel numbers. And so we see that all the time. We see 33 and 333 mm-hmm. all the time. And so he saw this right after. So that's that's sweet. You wait, like right after you bought it?
Mm-hmm. On my way home, I saw that after I literally purchased the ring, shot that video, and saw that.
December 18th, 2020.
It is parked next to me.
Wait, what is this?
That's just a hoey video of you naked in a shower.
Well, I'm not putting that in the YouTube video.
That's why I asked you to marry me.
Wait, but I did not know that you had the ring at this point.
Yeah, I did.
Wow, I can put a little blur effect on there.
But it's cute though.
Okay, so also during the pandemic, we were like trying to find ways to like maintain joy.
And have little vacations for like one night.
Because I've been in this apartment continuously this whole pandemic. And the only place I would go is like to the gym, to outdoor workouts, or to Target. I would walk around Target for fun.
With a mask on.
With the mask on. So this was like our way of, before we had a child, we were like, oh, let's continue to enjoy each other. And like,
so we did like one night at the Dream Hotel in Hollywood and got brick robes and like, we couldn't get room service, but we ordered the food that a robot delivered to our door. It was cute.
So good.
And we got to take showers in like a sexy shower.
Also, again. Side note, I gained weight since then.
Yeah, you look good though.
Okay,
next.
Shout out. Okay. Oh, you look cute.
Okay.
Okay, no, you don't get to talk.
Sorry.
I do.
That's Michaela.
I just took Michaela up because I need somebody to film this. And it's going to beep the entire time. She's not wearing her seatbelt. No, perfect. No, I just got Michaela. We're in the car. We're heading to David Yurman in Beverly Hills to pick up the ring. The girl I've been working with has it ready for me. Michaela, you have to put your seatbelt on, girl.
Oh my God. Why did it stop?
No, there's more videos.
Oh, there's more.
Going through them.
Oh, okay, I see it.
Wait, is that in 4K?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
I know you like 4K.
That means why'd she zoom in like that? Oh my God, Michaela. Michaela, first of all, never again. You were fired as a cinematographer, videographer.
This was her idea too.
And she has been telling me for months. She was like, oh, I'm so mad you haven't watched because you really need to see my skills. Well, I'm seeing it, girl.
So I just picked Michaela up. She is behind the camera because I need somebody to film this. We're going to David Yurman in Beverly Hills to get...
Oh, you reached that. Okay, I see.
I'm excited. I thought I'd be nervous. I bought the ring last week and I've not been nervous. The only people that know right now besides Michaela are my parents and his parents. And I called his parents the other day on FaceTime and I sort of asked for their blessing without really asking for it. But I said that we would appreciate your blessing. It would mean a lot to us. His dad was a pastor for many years, so I didn't expect to get a full blessing, but he thanked me for respecting them and calling them. And said that they would pray about it and that they were happy for us. And then his mom, who loves me, sent me a private text and she said that it meant a lot to her and to her husband that I called them. And then also she then messaged my mom and sent my mom an email that Emile sent to his parents over 7 years ago when he came out. His dad really struggled, both of his parents really struggled at first, religion of it all. And she shared that with my mom, and my mom just called me crying. So my family's super excited. I haven't told, like, I don't know if I can even go here. Am I going here?
I think, yeah, that's it. Let's go ahead.
Wait, pause. What email did I send?
When you came out, and you're struggling through it, and they were struggling through it, apparently you sent your mom an email? Or your mom sent you an email? I don't know. I'm sure my mom has it.
I'm gonna die right now.
Let's start that.
I haven't even told my sisters yet. Nobody really knows, so I'm excited. It's gonna be a good day.
Okay, check back soon!
excited and went on this journey.
So I did not expect this to be the way I did this.
For a day
off. Skip it all. But
Christmas
we're across
time.
The street. We're going to pick up the ring right now. Michaela's keeping me sane.
Yay!
It's a big day. It's a big day. I'm about to be a husband.
I was excited.
Hey, how did you?
I haven't watched these since then either.
It's time.
We're here. He and I looked at rings literally right here. Gosh, we've been in this store so many times over the last year. And now one of them is his. So we're super excited.
Yes.
Wait, did you feel like Kristen Wiig and I were like, oh my god!
I was practicing my Love is Eternal face the whole time.
Oh, that's in that clip. That's a little okay.
We're going this way.
Okay. Fine.
Also, it's been 8.5 years and he's waited, so he's earned this.
He's earned it.
Oh, we're doing a video.
Oh, we're doing a video. Wait, new location.
Right now.
There's better light over there.
I went to pick up the ring. I already purchased it last week, but we're getting it today. Real talk is the only ring that we've come back to time and time again. We looked at a lot of places, but it's the first one that Emile tried on almost a year ago. And I had a lot of different plans for proposing, and everything kept falling apart because of COVID. But I think this is going to be the most perfect plan of all, so simple. I like it.
You were nervous!
How long has he waited for a ring?
He's waited 8.5 years, so he's earned it. He's earned this ring.
Michaela giving B-roll
of
the store.
I was like, what is this? AJ in the background. A little Christmas tree.
She's like, honey, I'll get some footage. I'm like, go for it. She's better in front of the camera.
This is hilarious. I feel like I have to include this because she's trying.
She tried so hard.
Wait, you should have waited. I gotta rewind. Wait. Oh my gosh.
I wonder why it's like different now. You're like, that's actually his. Oh, it's so pretty.
Yeah.
It's beautiful. I think it's absolutely stunning.
Look at that.
Oh my god. It's beautiful.
It just catches the light like everywhere.
Yeah, it's...
Oh, it's so perfect for him.
That's gonna look stunning on him.
And we can get in the grape later.
Yeah.
My favorite purchase of my life. So cool. Oh, thank you.
Oh, I love that. That's so special.
It's.
Yeah.
He deserves it. It's so pretty.
Wow.
And I got you a smaller little box so you can actually put it in a pin it somewhere in the pocket. Oh.
Okay, here you go.
Oh my gosh, it's so wild.
Oh no, yeah.
A little gift for you too. Okay, so you can share.
Oh my gosh, thank
and the little
you.
Bracelet.
I appreciate
yeah,
it.
You're
thank
welcome.
You.
Thank you.
She's so friendly. So we just got the ring. I can't wait for Christmas morning. I'm so excited to give this to the love of my life. And to share it with our parents is going to be so special. And if he decides to share this with you, you'll be seeing this.
I was so excited.
Okay, so I'm getting emotional.
I can see this so long.
It's Christmas Eve and I'm doing his presents. And he is out right now, I think, doing some last minute shopping. I'm just so anxious, I just want to give it to him and it's driving me crazy. But I found this little box, a little Christmas box. So cute. I found this little Christmas box at CVS. And inside I got tissue paper and look. In there, so it's going to be the last thing. So I'm putting it at the bottom of our dog Kingston's Christmas stocking. We don't get him until January, but I'm telling him that my mom sent a bunch of things, stocking stuffers for the dog, because they have a dog, and he already knows that she bought us, my stepdad bought us a crate for the dog for Christmas. So I'm telling him that he can't open the stocking till the end, so after we Zoom with our family and open presents together over Zoom, I'm also recording it and telling him that I want to do an intro video of Kingston to the world, which is why I'm going to be recording all of this tomorrow. So he's not suspicious, I don't think, about why I have a camera out. Every time I look at this, get emotional. I love him so much. And he's waited 8.5 years for this, so I just feel so like proud of where we both come and like that I'm able to do this for him now. So Merry Christmas. It's gonna be a good day. It's gonna be a great day. We're so blessed. So wish me luck. If you've already seen this, then that means it went well. If you didn't, this all is going to be destroyed, this footage. Just kidding. It's going to go great.
Okay, so for context, just a couple years prior to that, I was in a really bad spot. Like, I had had a national talk show on a major network, and then I was replaced, and I was in a really bad place financially. You and I both went through some tough spots, but you were really, like, there for me for so long. And a couple Christmases prior to that, I had a dream of writing a book, and I started writing my book, and my laptop broke, and I was so broke at the time that I couldn't get a new laptop, and I wanted just to give up on it and not write the book, because I was just really like frustrated and overwhelmed and like defeated. And this guy went and bought me a brand new iMac desktop for our new desk that we just gotten, and gave it to me on Christmas morning. And he'll probably do some cool editing thing, and they show you that here. I remember opening it that morning. We had friends staying with us, and they were just like so overwhelmed, I think, by like his generosity, and like I couldn't even imagine that I could open a present that like extravagant, because to me at the time that was like the most extravagant thing I'd ever got in my whole entire life. Like I came from a super loving family. We always had really great Christmases, but like ain't nobody was getting like IMAX for Christmas. So when he did that for me, it was like the most extraordinary thing ever, and like it motivated me to write my book. And every time I thought about quitting writing the book, I thought about how much money he spent on that computer and how much like he didn't really necessarily have it to spend, but he did. And so I kept writing the book. So I wanted to give him something extravagant on Christmas also, which is kind of also one of the reasons I wanted to do it on Christmas.
I think seeing this footage, obviously we share parts of our relationship with you all. So if you followed us for a while, you're invested at this point. If you're new to this and you don't know the backstory, but we've gone through so much together, so many ups and downs, and not ups and downs in terms of like those relationships where you're like breaking up all the time, not like that. It's just, we didn't move out here for love or a relationship. We moved out here for a career. We're in LA, and we just happened to fall in love while also pursuing our dreams. And also we both are pursuing the same thing, mm-hmm. and we have been for years, and that's how we met. And I think just the fact that we found each other, and I know I wouldn't be where I am without him, and he wouldn't be where he is without me.
I don't know that I'd be alive without you.
Well, I
genuinely.
We can't talk about
that. I know, but that's real.
It's hard for me.
But that's real.
It's hard to think about that.
But like we spent one of his birthdays at Denny's because we were so broke and I couldn't afford to take him anywhere. So we researched, we looked up all the free things you could do on your birthday. And we went to Denny's so we could have his birthday. And then we went to Pinkberry because he loves Pinkberry, and they gave you a free small cup of yogurt on your birthday. And those are like the sorts of things we did for a while because we were struggling so bad. And people just assume that we're like balling, like we've always been just killing it out here. And it's not the case. And that was me broke after I hosted a national talk show on Fox. So like the ebbs and flows of this industry are so intense.
Yeah.
But this Christmas was special.
This Christmas was special. And also, just to put everything into context, for me, because this was December, I started working from home, like a lot of people, mid-March of 2020. Mm-hmm. And it was hard. Mm-hmm. I was here all the time. I was miserable.
And you think, like, it's hard because him in particular, he's been working from home this entire time, and it's, you know that so many people have it so much worse, and you feel so deeply for them, and it's almost like, I think that you've had a hard time expressing how hard this has been for you, because it doesn't compare to, like, the loss of a life or the loss of a job. We've been employed.
Right, and I used to be a server, yeah. And I have friends who literally have not worked the whole pandemic, so yeah. I said it. If they didn't even have a job and they're not complaining or they're dealing, then why do I have the right to even complain or to feel depressed or to feel anything? But it was hard. I was absolutely miserable.
And you absolutely have the right to.
And Christmas is our favorite time of the year. I got emotional just watching that. Not necessarily because what he was saying, because yes, because what you're saying, but also
Kelly Clarkson of it all is so good.
I heard Kelly Clarkson Christmas album in the background.
Wrapped in Red is one of the best.
It's one of the best Christmas albums.
It's like, it's right up there with Mariah.
We got into an argument with some friends, and then we'll get back to the video. Mm-hmm. We got into an argument with some friends who tried to argue that that Kelly Clarkson's Christmas album wasn't iconic. And let me be clear. Mariah Carey's Christmas album, top notch. Kelly Clarkson, right there.
Kelly Clarkson's Wrapped in Red is the best Christmas album since All I Want for Christmas Is You. And I will say this.
Say it, dude.
Like, Mariah Carey's like 1A. Kelly's not like 2. She's like 1B. Like, yeah. It's really, really close.
Yeah. And then, if you keep going down, you get to 1D. Remember that group? Okay. I love One Direction, but I also love
Harry Styles. Underneath the Tree is my favorite song of all
time. Oh my gosh. Okay. We love Christmas. Is this morning of? Is this Christmas morning? You're not in your onesie yet.
Yes, yeah, you're in bed still.
Okay, so Emile's still in bed right now, but it's time to set out presents and fill his stocking. But first, because I'm more excited about this, I feel like taste his stocking. That's where the surprise is going.
Now, y'all, this is, so I'm not gonna do a live reaction to this because I've seen it, and I'll just let you guys experience this. I'm not gonna show you the full thing because we were on Zoom for like 45 minutes.
But also, look how cute our apartment is.
Our apartment is so cute.
The snow underneath everything is so
cute. We were on Zoom for a long time.
Oh, there's Kingston's crate.
Oh, yeah.
Before he was here.
And I was definitely tired. Oh my God, my hair has gotten so much longer. Also, side note, y'all. It's weird looking at me back then because I lost a lot of weight during the pandemic because I work out a lot and I wasn't eating like I should have. And
I was thinner too.
I can't.
But I missed that version.
But I was tired. I'll show you guys bits and pieces. I'm not gonna make you guys watch all 45 minutes. But just know it was a very special morning.
This is not a motion picture. We're not making a feature film out of this.
No.
Okay, got it.
But just to give some context, and then I'll put in some clips.
Some what?
Some context.
What?
Context.
Context.
I'm saying context. I'll play it back. I'm saying context.
There's a T
times.
At the end of it.
And I've said it multiple times.
No.
Okay, I'm going to play it back and you're going to hear it. He thinks I'm wrong. I'm going to play it back and there's always context. Context. Context.
Context.
I'm saying context. Anyway, and then you're gonna look dumb because you're going to think you're correcting me and I've said context multiple times. Anyway, nobody says context.
Could you guys argue without talking?
People say context. Anyway, so... Basically, ignoring Mr. trying to correct me, our parents had never really interacted on they'd never met in person.
Our moms have.
Yeah, our moms have. Yeah. But our dads and our moms haven't like ever met all at once. So yeah. It's like a big deal. And also to put more context to it, we were actually supposed to go to spend time with our families for Thanksgiving and for Christmas.
Yeah, we're supposed to be with his family
in
Louisiana for Thanksgiving, and then my family for Christmas. For our big, big family Christmas for the first time in our lives.
And we've never spent the holidays with each other's families the whole time we've been together. So this is the year, and then 2020 happened. So this was a big deal, not just for us to be spending time with them, but also
because we could never afford the flights.
Yeah.
And we had the flights purchased already for these.
Not just that we couldn't afford, most of the time for me, and sometimes for him, for me, I would work during the holidays because that's when everybody would go out of town. I'm like, oh, that's extra shifts for me, whether it be serving or when I was at my hosting job, people go out of town. I'm like, oh, well, I can work. I'm available, and then whatever. So anyway, that's some context to this. I'm going to let you guys see some of the moments, and then we'll get to the actual proposal, and then we'll come back.
Right.
Well, yeah, and then back to L.A.
Yeah.
So we went, she flew here, and then I booked Wendy Williams randomly, and I was like, well, my sister's here, so I gotta take her with me. So I, one of her presents was I took her to New York for a couple days, and we saw Phantom of the Opera.
He's flying anywhere. Sharon, I'm flying in 5 days, though.
Where are you going?
I'm going down to Florida, down to where I always go with my girlfriend, or where her mom lived.
Oh. We all had one for the plane. It was really nice.
Sharon, did you get one?
No.
You didn't go to Bali.
Oh, wait, let me show you his ornament.
I can't wait to see Kingston. Well, I can't. I mean, you got to tell me how to get a picture for Bailey because I didn't get it on the tree.
Kathy,
you see the
one? Have...
You had one job.
See, that's the ornament I have, but I don't have a picture in it.
Kenzie, help her out.
Wait, I'll put him right here so he can open his presents with us.
Aww.
And we're recording this so we can send it to you guys afterwards.
Oh, nice. I can't wait to meet
you. What about, okay, so it is Christmas, obviously. So, Reverend Ennis, if you could start us off with a prayer, I think that would be wonderful.
That'd be great.
Let's bow our heads. How grateful we are, oh God, for your love for us, for your son, Jesus the Christ, whom you sent to save us. And how grateful we are for fellowship, for friendship, for love, for understanding. And we thank you, O God, for guiding us, blessing us through this pandemic, giving us health and strength, and we pray long life. We ask you to bless us now as we share with each other. This and all things we ask in your son's name. And everybody said, Amen.
Amen.
Wait, what if everybody didn't know what to say?
Thank you.
Yeah, we grew up Catholic. We don't say that. And everybody said, I've learned it over the years, though.
Basically, I love you both. Thanks for always supporting my dreams. Your prayers and encouragement keeps me going. Merry Christmas. And here's to 2021. Love, Emile and AJ. Oh, thank you so much. This one says mom. This one says dad.
Gosh, I want Emil to send me cards.
Me too.
I didn't get a card.
He didn't know I'm a card person.
Yeah.
I'm a card person.
Huh?
I'm a card person. AJ's not a card person.
In the teens today.
Yeah. 16 or 14. That looks good, AJ.
Oh, that looks good.
Monkey bread is so amazing.
It is.
Yeah, I cooked out on the grill this morning.
It was great.
It says, season after season, there are more and more reasons to be thankful for a wonderful son like you. Merry Christmas.
Christmas.
Bugs Bunny.
Love, joy, and peace, mom and dad.
Oh.
And have a little gift card.
I would like to just point out, though, I'm not saying that I'm Sharon's favorite son, but my card is bigger. I'm just saying, I just noticed that. To AJ, our favorite son, wishing you time.
It doesn't say that.
I know.
Wishing you time to stop and really savor all the good things about this season, and hoping that health and peace and love are yours in the coming year. Love, joy, and peace, Emil and Sharon. Aw, thank you.
And again,
it's appropriate.
Again,
it is appropriate.
After season, there are more and more reasons to be thankful for a wonderful son like you.
Did you hear what Steve said, Emil?
Huh?
He said appropriate because you're our favorite.
Makes sense.
Well, AJ answers me more than Emil. He does.
I do.
Okay.
Do you want to open the big one?
Oh yeah. Kathy and Steve. Hold on. We have to hold the ornament so Kingston can see.
Kingston, this is for you.
You guys know what it is?
We only know because I wrapped it, or whatever.
AJ wrapped it.
Kathy, did you order it and send it direct?
I did. I kind of did that with all the kids this year because we just not getting with anyone.
Location.
Look, buddy.
It's like a house.
You're great.
Oh, it says home sweet. Oh, it says home sweet home.
Oh.
It's a big crate.
It is a big crate.
I cannot believe you guys picked out that one, though. That was ridiculous. They picked it out, not me.
No, they did not. They did not. Emile did. Because Emile's fancy.
Emile picked like that.
It had great reviews.
Because Emile has expensive taste, just like his mother.
Sharon. It's a dog crate, for crying out loud.
It's beautiful.
That's good.
Well, we'll open it.
We'll send you a picture later. No, we're going to do Kingston stocking.
Now we have Kingston stocking.
I'll do one and then AD will do one.
Aww. I already know my heart. You need to open them.
Bailey's going.
She's like,
wait, it says squeeze me, smell me.
Well, it's supposed to be, so it's like a dog can smell. It's like an aroma that it's supposed to calm them.
Well, Bailey likes it because she can hear it.
Cookie filled candy cane treats for dogs. Vanilla flavor.
What pet stores are out there?
Everything.
Yeah, like Petco, PetSmart, and then like some fancy little smaller ones.
Oh, I saw this, the easy treat.
How big is Kingston?
Well, right now he's about 4 or 5 pounds, I think.
Oh my goodness, tiny.
Yeah.
He's going to be 35.
I bought 18 or 19.
Chicken flavored rawhide munchies. Is this what the thing goes in?
A mini Kong.
Is that?
Yeah.
Oh.
He squeezed it in there.
And then he plays with it?
Yeah.
Oh, it says fun to chew, chase, and fetch.
So you can put that stuff in there. We got the peanut butter is the one.
Is it another toy? I love toys.
So is Bailey.
So when is Kingston arriving, guys?
January 9th.
Okay.
They're driving them out here.
I thought it was the 5th.
No, you thought wrong.
Wow.
Goodness.
Jeez.
That's a Beyonce song.
Okay. That all it takes. I thought it was the 4th.
You thought.
They didn't sing. Right.
You sound better together.
Yeah, they do.
Yeah, Emile definitely helps AJ's.
Oh, so they'll get this out of the Kong?
They'll play forever trying to get it out.
Huh?
A Kingston Kong?
Emile's joke was better.
Don't do this to me.
Is this a Kong?
Not today, Kenzie. Not on my watch.
Not on my watch.
A ball for fetch. Merry Christmas. Where is it?
What is it? You better scoot up, AJ, so we can see you.
I'm supposed to stand up or can I stay seated?
It's either. You are my favorite person in the whole world. I love you more than literally anything. I didn't expect when I met you that we'd be here. I also didn't just know that this was possible for me. And the way that you have loved me and been patient with me and supported me when I was really just going through really hard stuff. And the way that you brought me back to God, back to church. I didn't expect that to ever happen. You're the love of my life. I'm obsessed with you. Will you spend forever with me? Yeah.
Oh god. Thank you.
So that wasn't a doggy treat.
That wasn't a doggy treat.
Oh, it was in Kingston stocking?
Yeah.
Oh.
I had to throw him off the trail.
Wait, you guys knew? This was all a ruse. This was all planned.
So you didn't have any inkling?
Huh?
You didn't have any inkling?
Well, with any major thing, I always wonder, but I never know.
But we've also spent, what, 9 Christmases together, and it hasn't happened, so he probably was giving up.
Did you guys see it?
Beautiful.
It's ridiculously beautiful.
It looks like an NBA championship ring. I think he's got so much bling on it.
I'll take a better photo to show you guys.
Yeah, it's beautiful.
You said yes, right? Yes. You did say yes. Okay, I didn't hear. I don't remember. I think I blacked out for. I blacked out for a second.
Don't mind me. I'm in a fiance now.
I thought you were gonna boohoo.
No, I cried a lot during quarantine. I'm really happy right now. I'm happy with life, and I'm grateful for a lot. So I've done happy tears before. I don't know. I'm just happy.
Well, he kept trying to do it when Sharon and I could be there, and then.
Oh, I had every plan. I had 10 different plans this last year, and every time I kept trying, to be this patient was so hard because it kept getting ruined by COVID, and then it just kept getting pushed back, and then then I was trying to do it with our family last week, and I was going to see if they would come up from Atlanta, but then things were bad, so nobody was comfortable doing that, and I wasn't going to ask them to drive up. I was going to try to get them a hotel or a small cabin or something to do it in Ohio, but then that didn't work. And then I literally was going to do it everywhere. I had it planned on red carpets. I had it planned on the Wendy show. I was going to reach out to Jeannie Mai and try to do it on the real one day. I had everything thought
Palm
out.
Springs.
Yeah,
Palm Springs.
Supposed to be at my birthday in Palm Springs in July.
Oh, wow.
It's been driving me crazy.
It's a process.
Because I was like, listen, God, I don't want to do a Zoom thing. And then I was like, okay, fine. We're healthy. We're happy. So I guess we'll Zoom.
And Kingston was here to experience it.
Hey, Emil, I didn't do any of those toys that were in the back. In the song.
Oh, you did? Wait, you were acting?
Well done, Kathy. Well done. She's... If you know mom, like Mackenzie and I would hear it, you know she started to oversell it a couple times. She would go into detail about some things. I'm like, mom, okay. You're seeing this for the first time, Kathy. Calm down.
You didn't see any of this stuff? Does Bailey really have some of these toys?
Yes. Yes.
Was that a lie?
Oh, she really did have that. And she ate the squeaky thing out of it, so we had to get that.
Fair enough.
Yeah. Well, we're going to do our Christmas now, I think.
Yes, I'm glad you all were here. Well, I guess I'll
see you. Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. We love you.
Christmas to you.
Merry Christmas.
Thank
love you.
Love
you guys.
Merry Christmas.
Christmas.
I wasn't sure. I thought you'd be sobbing.
Oh, that's sad. Okay.
Except me forever.
You locked it down.
Let me see if I got it right. Are you really happy?
Mm-hmm.
You gonna marry me?
Mm-hmm.
It tickles.
You like it?
Mm-hmm.
Twinkle, twinkle.
Little star. How I wonder what you are. Okay, so a few things. After the proposal, that was on camera. And then there was a moment, I don't know if that moment's on camera, where we had a conversation after. And he said something like, I thought you were going to be more emotional. And I told him.
Yeah, like low-key, I was like, why aren't you crying? I've been crying for weeks.
Well, I told him, I said, knowing that my dad was on the Zoom and knowing how, yes, we've come a long way, but my father is a retired pastor in the United Methodist Church.
47 years.
Yeah, and...
From Georgia.
I felt not uncomfortable, but kind of nervous because my now fiance is proposing to me, and then obviously we're gonna kiss, and I don't think that I've done that in front of him like that. And I think for me, there was like a protective barrier where I, because keep in mind, you guys are seeing this behind the scenes. At that moment, I didn't know that he asked my dad for permission. I didn't know any of that. So in my mind, I'm like, I don't know if my dad approves of this. I don't know if he's uncomfortable. It was like a lot of things going through my mind at the same time.
An update, I didn't really make it clear in the video, but his mother did, the morning after I asked for their blessing, I sort of approached it as we would really appreciate your blessing. Man to man, I'm going to marry your son regardless. I would never say that, but that's sort of like my mentality, because we've talked about it before him too. And I had asked Emile Jr., you know, what if we don't get their blessing? Then what? And just hypothetically over the years I've said that. And you're like, well, we're still getting married.
Yeah.
So I didn't really, I wanted him to feel as much a part of it as he chose to feel. And the next morning, your mom emailed me, or sent me a text at work, and because I host a radio show, so I'm at work at 5 a.m. every single day, a national radio show, The Morning Beat, check it out. And she said, you have Senior and I's blessing. And I started crying while I was at work that morning.
Senior's my dad, because I'm getting married.
So I did get the blessing.
And honestly, I wish, and there was no way he could have told me, but I wish I would have known prior to that that my dad had given his blessing, because that definitely would have changed my reaction.
I could have maybe mentioned it.
Yeah, but...
But like, I didn't want to make that part of the puzzle.
Yeah, and so in my mind, you know, my dad's on Zoom and I'm being watched. I'm like, I don't know. But I will say I, off camera, did get extremely emotional after I found that out. And the follow-up was calling friends and family and letting them know and doing the whole tour of... Hey, and we did this whole thing. We were FaceTime, like, hey, Merry Christmas, blah, blah. And then we, like, either hold the ring up or whatever. And they're like, oh, my God. And
we wore the matching. I got us matching onesies.
Yeah, which you saw in the video.
That our friend Jackie had. And she had the same one. They're co-ed. And it's super cute on her. So I found it online. And, it was and I got cute. Matching ones for the two of us. And then...
I'm thicker now, so I don't think mine fits anymore.
But we wore them the entire day.
Yeah.
We went to my Christmas with my family, who does live in California, my cousins. We spent Christmas Day there, and we picked up a bottle of Vouv on the way.
Yeah.
Because we're fancy now, and because we can, and we had a toast with everyone.
We celebrated. And it was a beautiful thing, and I will say one of the biggest questions from friends and family was, did you know? And I'm like, okay, no, I didn't necessarily know, but like every single major event, holiday, whatever.
For the last like 5 years.
I'm thinking maybe this could be it. So did I know? No. Did I know? Yes. Like, you know what I mean? Like,
you low-key thought I was going to propose in Bali, and then you thought I was going to propose on your 30th birthday because your mom was going to be here.
Yeah, Thailand. There were so many opportunities. Point being, even though I said I wanted extra, it was the perfect engagement, and it was beautiful, and I'm glad that my parents...
Wait, it was what?
It was the perfect engagement. And I'm glad that my parents were there, your parents were there, your sister was there. It was a beautiful thing, and... Now looking back, I needed that joy. I needed that moment during quarantine, and not like it's over, but I needed that. And it was, I don't know, it was just glorious. And I'm glad that we can finally share this with you all. And just quick update without going too much into detail. We found our venue.
We did.
We're getting married in Mexico.
Uh-huh.
We flew down there a few months ago, and it's,
we took two of our best friends, Sophia and Canelia, down there with us to check it out. Just so we could get a couple extra sets of eyes on it, because they're like, they understand us. Yeah. They've been there for every step of our relationship.
We'll tell you more about that later. Yeah, we're very excited.
Yeah.
But if you've stayed to the end of the video, we have another announcement.
Oh, yeah.
That we're very excited for.
Uh-huh.
Okay, so.
I feel like I should bring that in.
That's too much work. Something else that happened during quarantine was me being bored on the sofa. And one day I was on the sofa and I said, I'm bored, tell me a secret. I did not know that so many of you would spill your juiciest, deepest, darkest
secrets.
I was reacting, AJ was reacting.
No judgment.
And it turned into this thing. Well, it's been literally over 10 months of working on this, and we finally are announcing that we are launching a podcast together called Confess Your Mess. Oh, that feels weird. So anyway, if you are watching this, it's coming. It'll be available on every platform.
Uh-huh.
And we're also going to do the video version on YouTube after the audio version's released.
Yeah, and also we need you guys because every episode we're going to bring one, like one of our celebrity friends, to break down the secrets and to kind of maybe give advice or give thoughts.
And sometimes if you share a secret and we need some follow-up, we might actually contact you to come on the show.
Yeah.
So that's Kingston, come up here so we can say goodbye to the people.
Kingston, come say goodbye to the people.
Wow.
Kingston is a lot of that.
His hair.
Wait, come here. Come here.
Your
come
hair.
Come here, baby.
It's like smushed down on one side.
Oh.
Okay, anyway. Wait, you want to see something cute that we do? I love Dream Girls. And so we do this.
We are a family like a giant tree. Reaching up to the sky, we are a family.
We do this and we hug him.
He loves
him. Oh, God, I don't want people to like, I always lick my mouth.
If one of us is gone, he like freaks out. And if one of us walks into the other room, he can't decide where to stand. He stands in the middle so he can see the
phone. Stop licking my mouth.
He did.
Why are you licking my mouth?
Oh, God.
Why are you so cute?
No.
Beyonce and son.
He's got Kingston. He licked my mouth. Literally, guys.
Anyway, love you guys. We'll be back very soon. I know it's been a long break, but now that we have the podcast coming, there's going to be videos all the time. So
every Thursday.
Love you. And